Now, some of you may be familiar with the songs, the traditional New Orleans songs, Frankie and Johnny and Stagger Lee and things like that. And I always loved those songs. And Phil and I decided to write a version of that song, which was, and set it in London in the early 1990s, perhaps, in Camden Town, perhaps, maybe. Which is a place one occasionally hangs in. And so this one is called The Ballad of Psycho and Delia. In a rundown punk hippie bar, there were too many ghosts around, so they split in Psycho's car. Delia told Psycho it was true love at first sight. She'd been kicked out of her last pad, so she had to stay the night. Yeah. Confessed to Psycho her habits were still bad, made him warm towards her more. They were the same ones that he had. Yeah. So it goes,
so it goes.
These are the blows,
these are the blows.
Everybody knows,
everybody knows.
So it goes. Loved Delia, but they sure hated being straight. Lost his car and then his gig, and the loving turned to hate.
Turned to hate.
Delia left Psycho, she couldn't stand the pain. Hooked up with a young dealer, and she got right out of her brain. Miss Delia, she was the only one who understood. Stole himself a beat up Ford, and he searched the neighborhood. Delia caught Psycho's eye in that bar of 60 shades. She was too low to run away, and too high to feel afraid. Army knife, wrapped a chair around the dealer's head, shouting, "She could have been my wife." Delia cried, "Psycho, I really think I'm dying. I just want you to know that it was you and only you all the time."
Everybody knows.
So it goes. with. Love and drugs don't mix your kicks, or you won't be long around. Okay, well, this is a blues type of song. We love the blues. And this is about a bad man who came from a bad place and is determined to have a bad time and give everybody else a bad time. And he does this dance, which is called the dispute, which is he shakes his fist and when he's dancing because he's angry at just about everybody. So this is the dispute. To have a real bad night, I wanna jump and bump until the broad daylight. So hey little man, get out of my face. God, if I jump on your head, you'll be off the case. You don't get out of my way and I'll shoot. I gotta keep right on you. Dispute. you don't get out of my way and I'll shoot. Gotta keep right on you in the dispute, yeah. Gotta keep right on you in the dispute, yeah. Gotta keep right on you in the dispute, yeah. Gotta keep right on you in the dispute, yeah. Thank you. We continue in the blues vein. This is a song about an old British joke. The old British joke is about somebody who's been having an affair with his friend's wife. And he's up in a big high-rise block of flats, and they hear the sound of footsteps approaching the door, and she says, "It's my husband, you have to jump." And he says, "But this is the 13th floor." And she goes, "This is no time for superstition." It's an old British joke. And I always wanted to write a song about this particular joke. And it so happened that Phil and I came upon this little blues idea. So this is the 13th floor. Psychedelic sleep. This is the 13th floor, and you're saying that I gotta jump. This is the 13th floor, and you're saying that I gotta jump. You're telling me it's not far down, and I hardly feel the crunch. I could stay around for more. I don't want to see who's coming through that door. On the 13th floor.
No time to feel the superstition.
This is the 13th floor. You know, should have let me in. This is the 13th floor. You know you shouldn't have let me in. I don't know why you did, but this is the best place I've ever been. Oh, this is the 13th floor, and I know that you belong to somebody else, yeah. This is the 13th floor, and I know that you belong to somebody else.
Ooh,
I know that we've been doing wrong, and I really enjoy. enjoy it myself. I thought I could stay around for more. I don't wanna see who's coming through that door. On the 13th floor. Big Magnum piece. This is the 13th floor. Please hand me back my cowboy shirt.
It's under the bed.
This is the 13th floor. Please hand me back my cowboy shirt.
Look under the bed.
I just can't believe that being blown away won't hurt. I could stay around for more. I don't wanna see who's coming through that door. On the 13th floor. In Britain, fashion drives everybody mad, especially in London. Fashion drives people crazy. It makes them kill and maim and God knows what, rip and desperate for success and the fashion things that it brings. So this one we wrote about that. This is called, and it's in music as well, and it's not just in clothes, it's everywhere. And we wrote this one about the way they take old things and they make them new, especially in fashion. You know, they take 1961 and they make it into now. They say it's now, but it wasn't. It was still 1961. Anyway, this is called Clip-On Weirdness Kit. No, you're really normal, just faceless in the crowd. The only way you can be heard is by shouting out loud, joining in the golden circle of crazy people wearing purple. Yes, it is. You know that way is really cool. You gotta get into it. It's the time to get dressed up. About if you wanna lead the next dance and join the newly cloned elite and see their mansions from the street. Oh yes, you can. You know that way is really cool. It's like a constant hit. It's the time to get dressed up.
Clip on, clip on, clip on, clip on.
Thank you.
Hard to say now. During the early 60s, you were one of the leading beat poets. What did draw you to play music?
Oh, well, I thought I was leading. I don't think I was. I always loved music more than anything, and I was always listening to blues and jazz in particular, and then a bit later on soul music. And I got through my writing as a poet, then that was when Cream asked me to write for them, lyrics for them. And when I started to get hit records with them, then I took the opportunity to start singing and form my own band. And I had one band, The Battered Ornaments, and which was pretty rough. And then the next band I had was called Pueblo Octo, and Phil joined that. So we've basically been working together since 1970, long, long time, you know. The one thing we never did was give up, you know. We always had some kind of misguided faith, you know. It was weird. It's weird how, I mean, we've had so many problems trying to put this together, and yet here we are, you know.
Would you say you have accomplished your musical goals?
No, I don't think so. Maybe some bits, but not really, no.
Still working on it, really.
Still working on it, definitely. You know. I mean, for me, the mark of a good musician, really, is to say I can still learn things, you know, not to be complacent, not to do the same thing all the time, to keep thinking of variations and improvisations and different ways of looking at things, you know. That for me, that's what it's all about, is trying to carry on learning and get better for as long as you can and as hard as you can. I think there's You mustn't ever be complacent, you know. You mustn't ever go, oh, no, I've done it all now. I'm the bee's knees, I'm cool. You can't do that. I can't do that. We can't do that. You know, we're always going, oh, no, that could be that. Could be better. That could be better. You know, you've got to do that. You've got to do that, you know. Otherwise, we couldn't live with it, could we? No, not really. Okay, as promised, our song about terrible illusions and delusions, this is called Holy Smoke. So bright, all covered in glitter, promise and delight, spotlights that hit her. I'm moving it real fine, really good looker, wiggling my line, trying to hook her. And then she vanished in the smoke, trying to land that really big contract. Still in my hand, practically a fact. I'm moving on up to higher society. Just can't help feeling a little anxiety. And then it all vanished in the smoke. Golden coach. Thank you for staying with us. Well, we got two more to do. This one is from the record, which you can buy over there. And it's about the trade in human flesh, weapons, and just about every other thing you can think of. Despite the needs of humanity, we are being sold and we are being killed with weapons we don't need. That's my sermon for today. But we all want to stay alive, and these people are bad. So let's get rid of them as soon as we can. This is called Sneaky spot, trading man. South Africa, I got silver from Brazil. I got furs from Alaska, 'cause I don't care what I kill. fading man. On the bass, James Away. Yeah. On the guitar, the wonderful Alan Weeks. Yeah. On the vocals, Helen Hardy. And on the vocals, Rietta Austin. On the drums, the wonderful Jeff Allen. On the trombone, the beautiful and very young Ellie Smith. And the virtuoso on saxophones, Lee Goodall. On the keyboards and vocals, Phil Ryan. Yeah, Phil Ryan. Thank you. And finally, we will give you something you know.
Thank you.
Thank you. Once again, James Away, Alan Weeks, Alan Hardy, the lovely Rietta Rustin, the beautiful Jeff Allen, the extraordinary Lee Goodall, the wonderful Ellie Smith, the unbelievable Phil Ryan. Thank you very much. We hope to see you again soon. Thank you. Thank you.